San Diegans spend a lot of time and money maintaining lawns. They also use a lot of water keeping them green. But not Alpine homeowner Diane Barnaba. Barnaba pulled out the natural grass in the front and backyard of her home. She replaced it with 750 square feet of synthetic grass. The artificial turf covers a small patch in the front yard and more in the backyard.
There was lots of gopher holes, tons of dirt, big dirt mounds. Although the dirt was great for plants, it was not good for the yard. And we had two dogs, so we had to always try and figure out how to cover up the brown spots. And then the biggest thing, probably besides the gophers, were the rabbits. We had tons of rabbits coming in the morning and at night grazing, eating all the grass down to the nub.
4 years ago, Barnaba re-landscaped the property, adding drought-tolerant plants and the synthetic turf. She says replacing the real grass cut her water bills in half.
And my husband's back was saved quite a bit because he didn't have to mow and weed whack.
Barnaba bought her synthetic grass from Escondido-based Easy Turf. Easy Turf regional sales manager Mark Radicke says the company's field turf product is a good substitute for real grass.
You know, our turf is extremely environmentally friendly. The infill, for instance, is it's crumb rubber, it's recycled tires. For instance, to do a football field, it takes 100,000 recycled tires. That's 100,000 tires that aren't sitting in a landfill somewhere. Plus, you know, the whole product is 100% recyclable. So besides that, you're not putting nitrates, fertilizers, things like that into the ground. So it really is the perfect green alternative.
The recycled tires are used for cushioning. Radicke says the synthetic green polyethylene blades are lead and toxic free. Polyethylene is a type of plastic, the same material used in grocery store bags. He says the fake turf does get a bit warm on days when the temperature reaches 90 degrees or higher, but a spritz on the turf with a hose drops that heat, at least temporarily. Radicke also says the field turf is porous, so it allows water to soak through to the ground. He says the average cost is roughly $8 to $14 per square foot, depending on type of turf, ground preparation, and access issues. Radicke says business for the company has picked up significantly in the past 3 years as the cost of water has climbed. He also says the turf is now considered a viable landscaping option. But does the synthetic turf really feel like natural grass? We put it to the barefoot test.
Feels like grass to me.
While the synthetic grass may feel good on my bare feet, some say it's bad for the environment.
To me, artificial grass is just artificial. It doesn't belong in a garden. It's outdoor carpeting.
Nan Sturman is a proponent of drought-tolerant landscapes. She's written two books on California gardening.
Grass has some advantages. Grass does take carbon out of the air. Grass does cool the air. It does filter runoff and rainwater, etc. We just don't have enough natural rainfall to keep it going without a lot of artificial means. So if you can't keep grass going without artificial means, why have artificial grass? It doesn't serve any purpose other than being a green carpet.
Sturman recommends using drought-tolerant plants and a combination of soil and other ground covering instead of synthetic or natural grass. Dylan Edwards manages the Ocean Friendly Gardens program for the Surfrider Foundation. Edwards says synthetic turf does help conserve water, but Surfrider is concerned about runoff.
But underneath that synthetic turf, you have this really unhealthy compacted soil. And so the rainwater comes down, hits the synthetic turf, a chunk of it gets absorbed, but a vast majority of it runs off into the streets, into the gullies, the storm drains, and ultimately into the oceans.
He also says the artificial turf absorbs sunlight.
It's a petroleum product and that has some CO2 emissions related to it. It also absorbs a ton of the heat from the sunlight here in San Diego. And so what it's actually working to do is creating this little heat island around our city. And of course, you know, that contributes a little bit to the overall global warming picture, but also forces folks to run up their air conditioning a little bit more.
Edward says drought-tolerant and climate-appropriate plants are a better option because they absorb carbon and release oxygen. He says a UC San Diego study showed that if all landscaping in San Diego was replaced with artificial turf, it would raise the average temperature about 3 degrees Fahrenheit. But for Diane Barnaba of Alpine and other homeowners, the synthetic turf preserves a slice of the traditional green.
The issue was mainly having the grass that felt real. I mean, that was huge for me. And so having that and having a beautiful yard and not having to worry about a water bill, especially nowadays, you know, there was no question. It's I love it. It's perfect.